everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on the Orc Big Mech with Shokk Attack Gun. I'm going to work today on the leather strapping over here on the wrist, and then I'm also going to come in and do a little bit of highlighting work on these pipes or wires that we've got crossing the body here. It's a little bit flat, and so I want to fix that. So let's start off by sort of rebase coating some of that leather area because the paint has chipped just a little bit since last time. Just a touch. Also want to be able to clean up a little bit here. Now that wasn't good at all, now was it? Alright, so here's a quick lesson on how to remove paint from an area that you didn't want it in. I don't know if you can see, but I do have some brown on the cheek right there. So what I'm going to do is pick up some water in my brush, just water. And I'm just going to go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth across the area. And dry my brush, grab some more water, and do the same thing. And as long as you're relatively quick, within, 5-10 seconds, and I take a paper towel, just dab up the excess water, and good as new, no more brown. As long as you're relatively quick, you don't have to worry about the paint drying. Now, if it does dry, then you've got a slightly more challenging experience ahead of you, one that I don't want to get into in this video, but suffice to say, it is not an easy fix. So do be careful when you're working with your miniatures that you get the colors that you want in the areas that you want them to go. So, quick little lesson from my mistake. Hope you learned something. That concludes this video, ladies and gentlemen. We'll keep going. We'll keep going. Now, what I'm not going to do is I'm not going to touch this area up right there. I don't know if you can see that or not, but just on the corner of that leather strap right there across the chest, right there, there's a little white speck where the paint is flaked off. Now, I could go back and rebase coat that with this brown color, but there's no real reason to do it since at some point when I do my highlighting work over here, I should have a comparable color to what's supposed to go in that little spot anyway. So I'll just deal with that once I get to it, as far as the highlight color goes. Let me zoom back in just a little bit. There we go. All right, so that was a lot of noise at one time. Let's do some highlight work on, let's start with the red, I think. So I think I'm going to start with, let's go with carmine and just see where that ends up. I don't remember what I base coated this in. I think it was sort of a deep red. But carmine's a fun color. It's also fun to say, carmine. It's also a pain in the butt to open. Golly, man. Sometimes you need to be on steroids to get into this stuff. Got that roid rage, man. And even sometimes when you open it, the dropper bottle sticks into the actual cap, so in those instances, I just simply reach into the dropper bottle and pull out some paint with an old junky brush. And then gently, gently put the cap back on, hoping all the while that I don't spill paint everywhere. Set that up there. And let's drop some of that down. I think this is what I started with the last time. Pretty darn sure I have a comparable color on the palette that's sort of a dried puddle. So I'm pretty sure this is what I started with. And that's cool. No worries. We'll just rebase coat and get the area prepped for a highlight. So we're going to start here and I'm just going to go zip. Nope, definitely not the color we started with. Definitely not. Wow, that's actually much brighter. That's good. I wanted a nice, bright highlight in there. So you can see how it kind of fades out right about there down. You get a little fade out on that red. I like it. I like it a lot. All right. One would think Christopher had been drinking, except Christopher doesn't drink, so I don't know what the problem is. It's all the heroin. That's what it is. All right. Nope, just excited to be home, finally. Finally. Finally excited to be home and doing something that I want to do as opposed to something that I have to do. Don't you hate it when life gets in the way of you doing the fun stuff? It's so annoying. If I could stay home all day and do nothing but paint miniatures and have all of my needs met as far as food and clothing and shelter, etc., I think I'd do it. But who knows? I was there once. Didn't have all of my needs met. Had a lot of them met, though. Let's see. Can I go? I can't really go to that color. I could go here. Do I want to go there? That seems like an awful big jump. That's definitely not the color I want to go to. That's not big enough. Alright, fine. We'll go to orange red. Why not? Hello. Excuse me. Oh, fiddlesticks. That's not good. Alright, so. Orange red. No idea how this is going to look. But we're going to give it a go and see what happens. Okay, a little bit of this picked up on the brush. And I do mean a little bit, because I think this color is going to scream. So just want to apply it maybe up there near the top. Maybe a touch right in that area there. Okay. Wipe some of it off the brush. And then feather it into the red. In fact, I'm going to go into that previous vermilion color. And just help that blend in. There we go. Excellent. 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 Alright, now, let's see, where to go next? How about, let's see, let's do the green. Let's do the green, and I think for the green, I think I started out with a flat green, that's what it looks like. So let's rebase in flat green. Flat the green. Come on. There you go. It may be olive, but I think it's flat green. When you can get to the point where you can look at a color and decipher what color it was that either you used or someone else used, yeah, that's flat green, that either you used or someone else used to create that color, you have found a very cool area of miniature painting where you can color match things. And color matching is fun. Number one, it allows you to duplicate the things that you see other people doing in books and magazines and things like that. But one of the cooler things that you can do, and I've done this myself at several conventions, you can have people bring you their miniatures that are, let's say, damaged. I don't know if that's a good word to use or not. They've been gently used, let's put it that way. And in doing so, what you can do is you can sort of repaint them in a very similar color to what is already on the miniature. And I've seen several instances where I've done this, just where people have been gaming with their miniatures. Usually, I don't get a lot of armies that people want this done to, but individual character miniatures, you know, where corners where people have lifted things up, you know, lifted the model up, put them down over and over and over again for years, and things just get worn out. And you can really, really help people out a lot by being able to color match their original color with something new. And so it becomes a very, very cool sort of niche market that you can get yourself into. I remember there was one guy I did it for, actually, when I was at Origins one year. It was very cool. He had a Crocodile Games miniature, and he needed the cloak repainted. There was some chipping in the cloak area. And, I mean, the whole thing that I had to repaint was probably the equivalent of maybe this, tooth here, maybe twice that long and twice as wide. Very, very, very minimal area of the miniature. But I repainted it. At least that area matched basically what he had done the first time through, because he said he couldn't, you know, remember the colors that he used, and he didn't want to have to go back and try and figure it out or anything. And after I got done with it, it was one of the other vendors that was there. I went up and showed him what I'd done during one of my breaks, and was really impressed with what I'd done. He'd asked me to do a, he said, you know, it did a pretty good job on that. Can you do some detail work on the edge of the cloak? And I did. And it was very, very simplistic work. Nothing nothing out of the ordinary, just very simplistic patterning that he wanted on the edge of the cloak. And so I put it on there, and, you know, all told, it probably took me 30, 40 minutes to get the whole thing done, including repainting the cloak, or at least the section that I had to do, and then adding in the new pattern that he wanted on that area. And after all was said and done, I brought the model back to him at another break, and he ended up giving me very large Wendigo miniature from Crocodile Games, which, had I gone out and purchased it myself, would have been like $85. So, very, very lucrative, and it didn't really cost me a whole lot other than just my simple artistic ability of being able to figure out, you know, which color he had previously used, or come up with something darn similar to it. And so, color matching, always, always a proponent of it. Highly recommend that you learn how to do it. Alright. I believe this is ultramarine blue. Let's find out. Yes, it is. Zippy, zippy. There we go. So, I'm just putting a little hint of a highlight on some of these. The green, you can probably see it better if I cover it up. You can see it's a little bit lighter at the top there than it is at the bottom. Perfectly fine. Nothing wrong with that whatsoever. This ultramarine here, I think what I'm probably going to have to do is go into a little bit of white for highlighting this. I don't believe I'm going to highlight this with blue, because I don't think I have a blue that is in the same vein as that one that will lend me something similar. So let's go into white. Let's just put a dab on the palette, put the paint away, and then let's grab a little bit of that white, mix it in. Alright. Essentially got a wash here, it's so thin. There we go. Yeah, baby. Okay. And we'll add in just a touch more white. Just a hint. Well, maybe more than that. There we go. Painting with water. It's colored water at this point. Whenever I add white to something, I always become a little hesitant to highlight, because a lot of the times the highlight can be so overpowering. But I tend to end up painting with glazes whenever I do white highlights. It just makes the highlight more subtle. Makes it blend in better. Alright, last one. And again, very little, if any, paint on the brush at all. Hint of color there. Maybe just a little bit much. Let's wipe some of that off. Wipe it off on the paper towel. And then very gently just kind of pull that color down just a little bit. Perfecto. Okay, now I'm going to get some water because I'm thirsty. Ah, lovely. Now, let's do some yellow. Can we do some yellow? Let's. What do we want to use? Do we want to use flat yellow? Probably so. It's a good starting place. So let's go with the flat yellow, even though it's... I think I used golden for the initial... Good Lord Almighty, open up. Wow. I have to start getting a pair of vice grips up here just to open my paint. Jeepers. Some of these Vallejo paints, I gotta tell you, I love the paint. I really do. But these dropper bottles, sometimes they can be just ornery. Absolutely ornery. You don't want to open. They want to suck the frickin' eyedropper part up out of the bottle when you do finally get them open. It's just annoying. Alright, so just gonna sort of touch the front part of this yellow. I don't really want to get in on the side so much, just the front. And then what I'll do is I'll come in and I'll add like kind of almost an edge highlight in the areas where the yellow and the black touch one another. It's just a little drab here. That was the, that's my main issue for coming back in and working this area again. Once I painted up the, little goblin fellow on the base, and some of the rest of this orc, you know, this whole central area seems a little on the blah side. Not that the colors are not nice and bright and everything, they're just not as bright as the surrounding colors. So, I'll brighten them up some. Now, I'm going to take a little bit of that white that I had already on my palette. That's more than a little bit there, Christopher. Alright, and I'm just going to add that to the yellow to make a lighter yellow. Like a meringue color. Lemon meringue pie. Alright, we'll wipe some of that off. All I want to do here is just touch kind of where the black and the yellow meet together. And guess what? If I can't see where the black and the yellow meet together, I don't paint it. That is one of the biggest keys to painting stuff and making it look cool. If you can't see it, don't frickin' try to paint it. Makes no sense. Don't try to paint something that's not technically there, even though you know it's there. It'd be like if you were trying to paint someone's like profile from the side of their face, and you tried to give them two eyes. You know they have two eyes, but you can't see one of them, so don't paint it. Or don't draw it. Alright, so we're 18 minutes in. I think we'll in the video here today. Next time we'll come in, we'll finish up the leather here and on the vest here as well. And I don't know what I'm going to do after that. It's a mystery. I guess I'll find out, and you will as well, once we get to that point. But for right now, we'll call it a video. I want to thank you very, very much for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already, so you don't miss any of these awesome videos. Thank you once again for watching. I really do appreciate it. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.